This was when we met, and this is where we became really good mates. And we've had some really good times. Hi, I'm Billie Piper, and I'm going to be reacting to some of my iconic moments from my career.
I love you.
It's my last chance to say it. Rose Tyler.
It means so much to me because it was the beginning of my career as an actor, but first and foremost, it was the beginning of a friendship with so many people who I am still very close with and who I still see because we do so many conventions together. And it's so rare that you would get that opportunity to keep reuniting with people that you've worked with. You always say you will, like you always have good intentions, but it's often it's often forgotten about in a couple of weeks. It's a big deal in my life, this. And this scene particularly. And I don't know, so yeah. David and I we still see each other at conventions. I'm going to his birthday in September. So yeah, we don't see each other as much as I'd probably like to, but we've both got children, so it's impossible.
No more. No more.
No more.
Is that the clip? I don't know, I can never remember this stuff. I mean, it happened like 20 something years ago. All I can remember is Rose Tyler, run for your life. What else did they say? Oh my God, I can't remember. I smell chips. I think I will always remember this final scene with David, Doomsday, because I was so genuinely sad to be leaving the show. I knew I was leaving, and I was desperately sad to be leaving David as well. So, and it meant so much to me, it was so defining. And I knew it was one of those defining moments. And I think it was a sort of a cathartic way to process my exit, it made for something quite moving, I think.
Oh no, that would be dishonest. Of course I read it. All he said was he wanted their arrangement to start immediately.
My favourite memories of filming the series are Matt Smith. So sweet. Yeah, this was when we met, and this is where we became really good mates. And we've had some really good times. Oh, so cute. My hair is pretty much identical to that now. I think Honey to the Bee is one of my favourite songs because at the time I was into R&B and it felt like as close as I could get to R&B without totally deviating from pop, which was a very clear drive of my record company. And it also really reminded me of Never Ever by All Saints. Yeah, I don't want to say it was a direct rip-off from Never Ever, but now when I listen to it on reflection, it sort of seems that way.
I've noticed a change in Susie.
I have to be perfect.
None of this is worth it.
Are you happy with everyone hating you?
Well, no, it's not lovely.
It's so intense filming it. I mean, it's more intense watching it. Is that true? Is it more intense watching it than it is filming it? I think the stress of filming it sort of bleeds through into the finished product, but it's stressful, but it's also such fun. I suppose it's the most aligned to my sense of humour and who I am as a person. This doesn't represent me as in beat to beat, I am Susie Pickles, but it definitely represents my tastes.
Yay! Thursday, 2 p.m, the Palace. 2 chairs in the middle of the floor, 6 feet apart.
2 chairs in the middle of the floor, 6 feet apart. That it's Gillian Anderson, that she is a phenomenal actress, that I loved her as a kid. She's very warm, and it's funny, she often plays like chilly characters, but she's actually very warm, and there's some sort of fruity energy to Gillian. Thanks so much for watching, and our film Scoop is on Netflix on the 5th of April. So watch it.